died 30 years ago. Hope is mother.
Hello, I'm looking for Anne Shepherd's room. Please sign the visitor's book.
Oh, and here's where I kind of play games.
Are you a member of the family?
Yeah, you could say that.
Oh, she'll be pleased to have a visitor. No one ever comes to see her. With trouble remembering things, but it'll still please her, you know. It's room 19 at the end of the corridor.
Thank you.
Room 19. Where is that?
She just told you.
Only a few hours left before Shamar's dies. Hope I'm not wasting my time.
And hopefully this is the end of the game. Does this mean this is...
Room 19. Where is that?
Yo, tell me about your fucking mother and son.
Hello, Mrs. Shepherd.
Is it time for my pills already?
Yes.
No, Mrs. Shepherd,
They're never on time with my pills. I don't know what they do here. In the other hospital, they were always on time. But here...
Shut up and listen to me.
I came to talk about your son, Mrs. Shepherd.
My son? I have no son.
Do you remember John?
My Johnny. He is a good little boy, you know.
I know what happened at Carnaby Square. Do you remember?
Carnaby Square. I think I used to live there a long time ago. We didn't have much money at the time, you know. We had to make do with very little.
Oh my God.
Your other son, Mrs. Shepherd, John's twin brother.
Damn.
What was his name?
What other son? I have no other son. I never had any children.
Mrs. Shepherd, your son may be linked to a series of murders. Perhaps you have some information that could help the investigation.
Are you a new nurse? Where are my pills?
Try to remember, Mrs. Shepherd. John's twin brother was placed with a foster family after the accident. What was the name of the foster family?
I asked them for a television, you know, enough money. It's a pity. I'm fond of television.
You had a son named John, and John had a twin brother.
Do you have my pills?
Oh my God.
It's time for my pills.
I think your son is in trouble, Mrs. Shepherd. He's done some terrible things. I need to find him. Do you understand?
Terrible things you're telling me. He never came to see me, can you believe it? In 10 years, never. No one forgets their mother, do they?
So what now?
All right, no point in wasting my time. I won't learn anything more by staying here. This woman might be the origami killer's mother. Must be some way to get her to remember. It'd take days, if not longer, to find the name of the family that adopted her son.
You don't seem to get many flowers, Mrs. Shepherd.
No, but I love them. My son knows that I love flowers. I know he'll bring me some.
I'll get you flowers, you old bat. It's Dios.
All right. No point in wasting my time. I won't learn anything more by staying here.
Shut up. Hey, redheaded bitch.
Does Mrs. Shepherd ever talk about her past?
It's not all very clear to her now. Sometimes she'll remember the oddest things, though. I suppose if she sees something that reminds her of her past.
Did she ever mention her sons?
Sons? Well, she often mentions John. I think he drowned.
Does she ever talk about her other son?
I didn't know she had another one. I've never heard her mention it.
I'm looking for her other son. He was adopted. I mean, he's probably changed his name. Is there any official documentation on Mrs. Shepherd?
No. There's nothing, really. Nothing about her family. I guess if her son was adopted, then she's the only one who could tell you about that. Sometimes, if you show her things, it seems to trigger a memory from her past.
Yeah, I got it.
You might get it to remember.
Thanks for the advice.
Oh my god. That was not fun at all. Don't thank her. Hey, you little broad in the corner. Trevor, I brought you an orchid.
What a lovely orchid. My sons loved orchids. We used to grow them in the back. When John died, I laid orchids on his grave.
What's this?
Are these your children, Mrs. Shepherd? John and his brother? Is that them?
They're good little boys. Their father never looked after them, always drinking. They didn't have an easy life, you know. I love origami, but that's not my favorite one.
Oh my god. Hey, no, hey. The dog. The frog. Money on the dog. Everybody fucking likes dogs.
Oh, you know how to do these little dogs too.
Fuck yeah.
My children loved origami. I taught them how to do it. John loved the little dogs. He always wanted to call them Max. Max, Max, oh. Max. All dogs with the same name. I was wasting my time telling him they couldn't all have the same name. But he always wanted his paper dogs Max. It's funny, isn't it? I cried when they told me. I'd already lost one of my children. And now they were taking away another one, you understand?
The Foster family, Mrs. Shepherd. What was the name of the Foster family that adopted John's brother?
They were really very nice people. I met them, you know. In the beginning, I used to go and see my little boy. And then I got sick and I couldn't go any longer. Perhaps he thought I'd forgotten him. He must have thought I didn't love him anymore.
Well, you didn't, right?
His name, Mrs. Shepherd. What was his name?
But I loved him. If you only knew how much I missed him.
Please, Anne. His name. What was his name?
Come closer.
Oh, why?
The last origami figure. The last trial.
Last origami.
The last origami figure. The last trial.
The last trial. The last question. Are you prepared to give your life to save your sons? There is a deadly poison in this file. It will kill you in exactly 60 minutes. If you drink it, you will get the last letters of the address. You will have enough time to save your son and say goodbye to him, but then you will die.
Jesus.
You can drink the file or decide to leave. The choice is yours.
I need to save Sean.
Jaeger bomb, are you shitting me?
The last letters have been sent to your phone.
Fuck. Don't have all of them, that's bullshit.
I did what I had to, Sean. Your dad's coming to save you.
Maybe.
Nowhere, and I'm out of time to have fucking shitty letters from this fucking address! Come on! There's gotta be a way to do this! several different addresses fit these letters. God, they're scattered all over the city. I don't have time to check them all. I may only have time for one address. If Sean's not there, I'm done. It's a crapshoot.
No, don't do it again. No.
We've only got a few more hours left to save Sean Mars. There has to be a goddamn clue somewhere. It's probably staring me in the face. This kid's gonna die, and I'm going around in circles!
All packed up and ready to go?
What are you talking about?
The investigation's over. We know who did it. No longer need your services anymore, Norman. So you can ride your files all the way back to Washington. I'd be lying if I said I was gonna miss you.
All right, Dick.
The investigation isn't over. You have absolutely nothing on Mars.
Mars is guilty. Case closed. Anyway, it's no concern of yours now. You're off the case. So pack up and fuck off.
Blake, you are an unbalanced, psychopathic asshole!
I'll take that as a compliment. Honestly, I don't give a shit what you think. I found the origami killer. Everyone's happy. End of story. Have a nice trip back, Norman.
The killer's name is here. Somewhere in this data. I just have to find it. Find it before it's too late.
Oh, one last thing, sir. You should be careful not to overindulge in you-know-what. It can be dangerous. Very dangerous.
Okay.
It'll end up killing you if you're not careful. That would be most unfortunate, sir.
There's always a railroad line adjacent to where the bodies are found. And all the victims disappeared in the fall.
gun the killer left at the Blue Lagoon. Perhaps there's some way of tracing its history.
Oh.
Impounded in a police case 5 years ago, the gun is still supposed to be in police custody. Who checked it out? If not a cop. Ari was in record mode when I was fighting with the killer. Perhaps there's something on it. Gold watch. I'm sure I've seen this before somewhere. The watch killer is a cop! Sword was already in Paco's office. It's got nothing to do with the killer.
Okay, then.
Looks like the killer is a cop. Carter Blake! That would explain the dead-end investigation and his desire to frame Ethan Mars.
Unfortunately, there's going to be a little break because I got to go get Jake. Oh my goodness. Wow. Okay.
I can't go on. I can't go on.
I don't think I'm doing a very good job this playthrough.
Someone, then we'll come back and save you. Mom's work is too far away. I'd never make it in time. This place is completely deserted. There's no one around to help. Dad, I've got to get Dad. He's the only one who can save John. Gotta move.
Shit, Dad.
I tried, John. I really tried. But he wouldn't come. Please don't die, John. Please.
Don't forget about this, Scotty.
Scotty, don't be a pussy. Didn't realize that by just not like breaking the windows by before untying her from the car would he would just like fucking leave without her, and that's what happened. I was like, oh shit, oops, my bad. But oh well.
work quick.
Fire in an apartment is just not a good idea. Madison Page. At least one person can save Sean. Knock, so hopefully nobody's home.
You touch, girl. The origami killer's apartment. There must be something that'll tell me where Sean Mars is. I'll go through it room by room, but there's bound to be some kind of clue. A cop's uniform. Always dressed a cop. That's why children went with him. He was dressed as a cop.
No, wait.
This is where he cultivated the orchids that he left on the chest of his victims. Sean Mars! Oh, the lunatic's been watching him drown! It's some kind of a...
Shit, it needs a password.
Oh, damn. Shepherd. Fuck. Oh, wait.
Got it. Max. The name John gave to his paper dogs when he was a child. What the hell is that? An address. It's gotta be where Sean Mars is. Hurry. There's no time to lose.
Did I pick the right one as Ethan? Oh, shit.
So you found my little secret?
It's over, Scott. All those children killed just to find a father capable of saving his son?
Shut up! You don't understand.
There's one child left. There might still be time to save him. Let him go. Do what your father couldn't do.
Get in there.
Oh, What?
That's for them, sure. Well, okay, here I am. Oh, shit. Obviously not working. Stop.
I know where Sean Mars is. I've got to call that FBI guy, Jaden. He's the only one I can trust. He'll be able to save him.
Focus. Ethan's already on his way there, I'm pretty sure.
My name is Madison Page. You don't know me. I'm a journalist. We don't have much time, so listen carefully.
Ethan Mars is innocent. The killer's name is Scott Shelby. Sean Mars is at 852 Theodore Roosevelt Road. You got all that?
Hold on, how did you
know? No, please, I'll explain later. You can call my newspaper, the American Tribune. They'll tell you who I am. Please hurry. Sean Mars may still be alive.
Okay, I think I got everyone there. Pretty sure I guessed the right answer. Time to play as Sean. Cold as ice. Oh, weather outside. Clever dad. Ah, yeah. I did guess the right fucking place. Yeah! Push this way.
Sean!
Looking for a father that would be able to do what mine could not do. Sacrifice himself in order to save his son. Oh, I searched, searched, searched. And then I remembered you.
All those murders, just to find a father capable of saving his son.
Just to find a father? Do you have any idea how it feels to be a worthless nothing in your father's eyes?
No, my dad.
Believe
my
me,
thing.
I've suffered just as much as my victims.
I finished your damn trials. Now give me back my son.
He's there. All you have to do is open that grave.
Go, David, to cover me. Go!
Gotta open this goddamn grate. Gotta find something fast!
What do you want me to fucking find, Ethan? Oh, wait. Oh. Rebar. Oh. Fuck yeah. Agent Thomas Jaden.
potion? Fucking do this.
Sniper's in position?
Yes, Lieutenant. They're ready on your command.
Perfect. He won't get away this time. We'll gun him down as soon as he shows his face.
Hey! You there! What are you doing?
Lieutenant, my name is Madison Page. I'm a journalist. I have proof that Ethan Mars is innocent. He's not the origami killer.
What is a journalist doing here? I thought I told everybody to keep their mouths shut. Get her out of here. I don't want her getting in the way.
Okay, Lieutenant. All right, come on.
You're about to make a terrible mistake, Lieutenant. Ethan Mars is innocent. I can prove it.
Ow!
I can post up too.
God.
Dad, I knew you would come and save me.
But it was kind of your fault I was kidnapped.
Sean, listen. You are the best thing that ever happened to me in my life. I want you to know that whatever happens, I love you more than anything in the world. I'm not there. I took poison an hour ago, and I'm not dead.
I knew that was just a close friend.
Ash, get her out of my face.
Mars didn't do it, for Christ's sakes. He's innocent.
Fucking driving controls are stupid.
What do we do, Lieutenant?
All personnel, hold your fire. I repeat, hold your fire.
What's going on?
The cops. They're out there. They have the building surrounded. They'll shoot you if you go outside.
I'll go out alone. I'll talk to them. I'll explain.
You'll be dead before you can open your mouth. Look, we'll all go out together. With our hands in the air, and they can't possibly shoot us. I have the evidence that proves your innocence.
Listen, I'm sorry I didn't trust you. I was only thinking about Sean, and I thought...
That's okay. The only thing that matters is that you saved your son.
Riot shield up here, thank God. Oh my God.
There was general relief this morning when this alive, more than 4 days after his disappearance, Mars had been imprisoned in a well by the man known as the Origami Killer. The successful resolution of this case was made possible only by the bravery of Ethan Mars, who the police believed at one point to be the killer. It is no doubt due to his great courage and tenacity that he succeeded in foiling the plans of the Origami Killer. The police commissioner presented him with an official apology today. Our main headline today, it is reported that the police have identified the man thought to be the Origami Killer. Scott Shelby, 48, is a former police lieutenant who claimed to be a private eye hired by the families of the killer's victims. Shelby was killed during a massive police operation, but further details have not yet been released to the public.
Let's just say a friend of a friend let me jump in line. If we like it, it's ours.
It's weird seeing them in different clothes now.
Hey, Dad! I think I found my room!
It's
it just one big studio apartment for a family? That's a
it's perfect, Ethan. Home. We'll be able to forget what happened. We'll lead a normal life. And one day, it'll all just seem like a bad dream.
Not until Sean is
gone. We've earned the right to be happy now, Ethan. All three of us.
Fuck you, Sean. I hate new mommy Madison.
Our guest today is on the cover of Today's World magazine this week and has been hailed by the whole nation as a new hero for our times. Astonishingly, he almost single-handedly ended the sinister series of killings by the man known as the Origami Killer and saved the life of young Sean Mars. His determination, courage, and intelligence have won our admiration. Norman Jayden.
No, okay. He did not. He didn't single-handedly do shit. Throw that away. I didn't make you take any of that. Aw, hell yeah. Don't flush a fucking vial down the toilet, you jackass. That's gonna wreak havoc on plumbing. So, you're in the fucking game, are you just supposed to, like, not use sunglasses and shit? Like, what the hell? Only when it had me use it. That's just, like, that's why I'm really wondering.
I want to see them again. I'm a father too.
Jesus. Ah.